Hi, this is Jamie with FOSDP, and I am live at the City of Refuge for the 13th annual Stop the Violence, Put Christ First event, sponsored by Dorean Edwards. She is a phenomenal woman of God who has created such an amazing event. And I have with me today a special guest, Reverend LeSean Tarkington. How are you doing today, and what brings you to the Back to School event?
I'm doing fine. First of all, let me give a shout out to the members of the Kappa Alpha Psi Fraternity Incorporated. Thank you. But I was asked by Dorean Edwards to moderate the Young Entrepreneurs Panel, which I think is going to take place tomorrow.
Yeah. Why is the Back to School event so important in your life?
Well, you have to go to school. You have to continue your education. I'm just a recent graduate, actually, of the Interdenominational Theological Center. So I obtained my Master's of Divinity and a Certificate in Nonprofit Management. In this day and age, you have to, or not that you have to, but it's important that you finish your education.
Right.
Everybody wants to be on the basketball court, but nobody wants to own the team.
Right.
Everybody wants to sing in the concert, but nobody wants to be the promoter. Or nobody wants to own the building that the concert's being held in.
You hear that, you guys? He's talking about owning the building. Now, what I want to ask you is, first, I want to know what you will be doing on the panel. What is the panel about for our audience that won't have a chance to experience this event?
Well, tomorrow is a power-packed panel with young entrepreneurs. Of course, when we talk about entrepreneurship, we're talking about owning your own business. And some people think because you own your own business that it's easier, when actually, it's twice as hard. Because you're working beyond the 9-to-5 regime. You're working from 9 to 9, 9 to 12, 9 to midnight, 9 to 3 a.m. depending on how your business is flowing. Nissan Stewart, who was the judge for making his band with P. Diddy, is one of our panelists. And so many more will be talking about how to start your business, how to use the gifts that God has given you to be able to reach those beyond the local walls. Those beyond the local walls of your church, those beyond the local walls of your school, those beyond the local walls of your community. And in this day and age, with the economy failing, you have to think global. You have to think beyond your particular community. You got to think of more on a national scale.
Now, you talked about thinking globally. How do you keep Christ in the thinking globally? You know, you want to think globally, but you want to keep Christ first.
One is developing a relationship with God. One is developing a relationship with God. Two is understanding the gift that God has given you. One, develop a relationship with God. Two, understand the gift that God has given you. Three, you have to be active in somebody's local church. You have to continue to get the word fed to you so that when obstacles come, you won't give up or throw in the towel. You'll be able to withstand the storm that you're going through. So one, develop a relationship with God. Two, understand the gifts that God has given you. And three, get active in the local church. This is an awesome ministry when we talk about global ministry, because Bishop is global. And so now we have a global bishop, a global leader, and then so now the youth ministry, the young adult ministry has to be global, which means I'm doing myself a disservice if I'm not thinking global, but I'm sitting under a global ministry.
That's great. Now, what do you do? Tell our audience, FOSDP, what you do exactly besides being a minister, because you talk about being globally and thinking outside the box, having your own, you know, just being in charge of your destiny.
Well, 2009, I was featured in Ebony Magazine as one of the young leaders under 30. I sit on the board of trustees of the seminary that I graduated from. I also host and will actually be relaunching an internet radio show talking about issues that affect youth and young adults. I'm getting into the large portion of concert promoting. Gospel concert promoting, since I'm in ministry, can't really do secular. So doing gospel promoting and those kinds of things. You have to learn how to create multiple streams of income. And me recently being married and having a wife who likes St. John suits, I have to have multiple streams of income.
Now, you just touched on something very important.
The St. John suit?
No, you touched on about... with our audience, what I like is that you talked about you have to do gospel music because you're saved. Now, you have so many gospel artists that are, they're trying, they're doing movies, they're starting clothing lines, interacting in a secular realm. How do you keep Christ first in a secular realm when so many people in the secular realm don't believe in Christ?
Well, I'm glad you said that because I was on Sister. I used to be on Saved by the Bell. If I did not go into ministry full time, I probably would have been a road manager and would have gone to the secular side of promoting. But because a lot of my friends who were in the industry know me as a preacher, they wouldn't allow me to go on the road with them. So I had to figure out that I had all of this talent inside of me, all of these leadership skills. How can I channel them in the right direction? The clothing lines and all that, being in movies, is fine, but you have to understand. Bishop Noel Jones came to me one time and did an hour of power on the HBCU campus in Atlanta, and he preached on the topic, prophesy to the prophets. And so you have to understand that developing a relationship with God and with Christ doesn't mean that you stop being on TV, being in movies, but that you just understand that I may not be here for the movie check, but just to speak into someone else's life. A producer may be going through some. For example, I was on Sister. One of the co-stars, mother was dying of cancer. I would have been doing myself a disservice and God a disservice if I didn't encourage that brother that was going through during the transition of his mother. I could have been selected to be on that TV show just to be able to speak into his life. And so that's what we do in ministry. We don't stop being on TV. We don't stop the clothing line, but we understand that it's more than just being on TV. It's actually speaking into someone else's life.
Just sitting here talking to you, I can feel the spirit, and I can feel that it's a genuine relationship with God. And what I want you guys to know out there is that you can reach for success. You can have all that you've ever dreamed of having, but I want you to be like the Reverend, keeping God as the head of your life, letting God know that he is the pilot. You're the co-pilot, but he is the pilot of your life. Do you have any last words for our audience?
Well, these are the last words. We graduate high school. We go to college or trade school. We start a family in that order. Once we do things out of sequence, then it takes us longer for us to get our lives back into sequence. Keep God first, develop that relationship with Christ, and then after developing that relationship with Christ, you have to allow God to direct your path, and then you'll discover true success.
Now, Reverend Tarkington, it's been a pleasure. It's been a pleasure talking to you.
All right.
Thank you.
Look at that.
But you are, I could just... amazing, like global, going global, doing all these great things, but you still know that Christ is the head of your life.
Hi, my name is LeSean Tarkington, and you're watching FOSDP, Gifted, Uniquely Inspired by Christ.